Hello everyone, welcome to the second part of the poem, The Brook. Let's do a brief summary of the previous class that we studied. This is a poem in which the brook itself is narrating its story as a first person. The poet has personified the stream and it talks of its beginning, the journey through various landforms and finally its destination, which is the river. We can also see that the poet compares a man's journey of life to the brook's journey. The brook is eternal and flows forever, whereas man is transient. The brook says that man comes and goes, but I stay forever. Now let's continue with the further stanzas, coming to stanza 5. With many a curve my banks I fret, by many a field and fallow, and many a fairy foreland set with willow, weed and mallow. Explanation: with many a curve my banks I fret. Now here curve means a twist and turns that the brook is taking. Banks means the edges of the brook. And fret means to wear off in anger. So here with many a curve, that the brook is saying that when it twists and turns, the edges of the brook gradually wears off. By many a field and fallow, when it's passing through the fields, and fallow means uncultivated lands. And many a fairy foreland set, and when it's passing towards the beautiful places that seems like a fairy place. And foreland is a piece of land that extends into the sea. With willow, weed and mallow. Willow, weed are the kind of shrubs and mallow are the plants with hairy stems and leaves and have pink, white or purple flowers. Okay, the poetic device used in this is inversion, that is in line 1. Inversion is what? When the object is placed before the subject. So here you can read, with many a curve my banks I fret. I is the subject here and it's placed after the object. And what is the object? Many a curve. Now the second poetic device is alliteration. What can we see? Alliteration is what? That is the repetition of a consonant sound in the beginning of two or more consecutive words. Now here we can see field, fallow. The repetition of fur word can be heard. Again, fairy, foreland. Again, the repetition of fur word. And the third we have here is with willow weed. So again, the ver sound can be heard. The rhyming scheme is the same, ABAB. And the rhyming words used are fret and set, fallow and mallow. Stanza 6. I chatter, chatter as I flow to join the brimming river, for men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. I chatter, chatter. Now we already studied chatter means to talk non-stop. So here it refers to the noise as the brook is flowing. So what is it saying? It's making a noise as it's flowing to join the brimming river. We know brimming is what? That is filled, full of water up to the brim. Okay, filled till the mouth. So here, brimming river is the destination of the brook. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. Now again, the last three lines, we have seen that it's repeating. It's repeated in the previous that we learned in stanza 3. This is stanza 6. And it will also be repeating in 9 and 13. So here, what the brook wants to tell us, that man, they are born and they even die. But I keep flowing and I go on forever. It means that men are transient, temporary, mortal, but the brook says that it is eternal. The poetic device used is here repetition, that is the last three lines. And second thing, the word men may, it's repeated twice. The next thing is repeated, that is chatter, chatter. Twice it's repeating. The second poetic device is onomatopoeia, that are the sound words. So here chatter is the word, that is onomatopoeia. Third is alliteration. The word men may, you can listen the m sound in that. Now twice it's repeating. And the fourth poetic device is antithesis. Antithesis are the opposites. So here now the word come and go, that is antithesis. The rhyme scheme is ABAB, and you can yourself identify the rhymed words. Stanza 7. I wind about and in and out, with here a blossom sailing, and here and there a lusty trout, and here and there a grayling. Here, wind about means meandering, that is moving in a zigzag pattern. It doesn't have the same pattern, it twists and turns and flows, okay? It's flowing in and out as well. And here and there a blossom sailing. Blossom, that are the flowers. So what it's saying that here, with here a blossom sailing, sailing means moving together. So when many flowers fall, and the brook and the flowers, they all both move together. And here and there a lusty trout. Lusty means greedy. And trout, they are a big fresh water fish. So those greedy fishes, when they enter into the brook. And here and there a grayling. Grayling also, these are the other type of fish. In this stanza, the poet is comparing a man's life experience with the brook. As we can say, the blossom sailings are the happy instances of life. And lusty, that means greedy. Okay, so these are the bad experience in man's life. Another thing, grayling. Grayling refers to the shades of gray, that is neither being happy nor sad. They are the normal experience that humans face. Poetic devices used here are antithesis. Antithesis are words which contrast or have opposite meaning. So here the words in and out and here and there. For the second poetic device, we have repetition. They are the words or sentences that are repeated. So the words here and there are repeated twice. Moving further to the eighth stanza, and here and there a foamy flake upon me as I travel, with many a silvery water break above the golden gravel. And here and there a foamy flake. Now the brook is telling us that when it's moving fast, foams are formed on the surface of it. Upon me as I travel. So above it, over it has got foams, and when it's traveling along with the foams, the foamy flakes. With many a silvery water break. Silvery water break is the silver color. Above the golden gravel. Gravel is means a kind of sand. So the sandy surface of earth beneath the brook, it seems to be golden in color. The poetic device used in this stanza is alliteration, that is foamy flake. The first sound can be heard, and second is golden gravel. The g sound can be heard. The other poetic device is antithesis, that is the opposite. Here and there is the example for antithesis. Coming to the ninth stanza, and draw them all along and flow to join the brimming river, for men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. And draw them all along and flow. Now here, when the brook is passing, it's taking them all along. Them are who here? The blossoms, the fish. It's taking it all when it's passing and it's going through its destination, that is the brimming river. For men may come and men may go, that is that men are transient. They come with their birth and they go from the earth with their death. So men are transient, temporary, mortal, but the brook is everlasting, ever flowing. The poetic device used here is alliteration. You can listen the sound of m in these words, men may. Okay, it's repeating twice. And the second one is antithesis. Antithesis means the opposites. So the words come and go here are antithesis. Next one is repetition. Repetition is any word or sentence that are repeated again and again. So here we can see the last three lines, they are repeated, and the words other than that, men may, it's repeated twice. So with this, I've explained you stanza 5 to 9 in this video, and in the next video, we'll be understanding the remaining stanzas.